Expires and you have, well, it sounds like a board game, but at least it's a European game. Anticipation for the NES by Rare, no less. Weren't they Ultimate at one point? Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm a Spectrum kid. I've got a Rare collection and it had Jetpack on it, amongst other Ultimate games. It might have even had Sable Wolf, which I quite liked, regardless of it being ridiculously hard. This is going to be a board game. Bear with us. Come on, we're not wusses. We can do medium. It's a board game. I am a pair of shoes. Alright, my favourite thing to be. A pair of high-heeled shoes. What's going on? On the alphabet. Food. That has got to be eggs. I've no idea. No. What about last chance? God, that's a bit harsh. F. That was accidental, but... Wow, that was harsh. And kind of unfair. What it did is it said last chance, and I was tapping the button to get through last chance. And the button was doing nothing, and then after a little time of waiting, it just kind of went. Oh! Okay, it's a picture. What is it? It's a parallelogram. It's cheese. It's a cake. Cake. Oh, I'm getting it. I see. Like Pictionary. Oh, Words with Friends. What was that word game? It wasn't Words with Friends. Was that word game on the iPhone that had like, you could draw? I used to love it because I'd spend ages doing the drawing. And people used to really, like the drawings. So my ego loved it. It's a fish. It's a fish. A whale with her atlet. Yeah. I'm going for it. Sorry, that was W-H-A-L-E. I still spell like a child. I think I'm dyslexic. I am convinced I'm dyslexic. Undiagnosed. Come on. This is good. It's rare. It's probably going to be good. I didn't think this would be good. I'll be honest, I've written this one off as being rubbish. The name sounded like a board game. Board games never translate to games. This one does. Alright, I'm going to do this. What's that? It's like a fox with flamingo or a duck. Duck? I'm going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Patience, patience. Boot. So blur your eyes. It's... What the heck is that? Cheese again? Is it? Am I not seeing it? It's cheese! It's cheese! It is actually cheese. I thought I was just seeing cheese and everything, but it is cheese. Cheese. Alright, it's limited by the fact that it's a video game and the whole typing text in to say what you want to say. You want to go, cheese! But you can't, you're fighting with this. It seems to pause while you do it, which is cool. And the other player doesn't get involved for some reason. Although there should be another player on the board, surely. Unless the one player experience is just this. Man-made. It's like a bone, it's not a bone. Man-made. It's a... Oh no. Blur the eyes. Let the image come. House. Look at the number of letters, Mikey Diddy. Gravestone? Looks like a gravestone. Okay, I haven't looked at, not a gravestone. What is it then? Oh, come on, I don't know. Oh no, I've got to guess. I've got 20 seconds to guess. It's a tombstone? It's a tombstone. Roman Americanisms. Oh, now I'm fighting the timer. Oh, I didn't take the T. Oh, not fair. Not referee. No one can answer. I can answer the tombstone. I'm saying it. Right. Oh, I'm not happy about that. Mammy, what are you? Some kind of flamingo. It's always a flamingo, a piece of cheese. A wicket. I guess if you're playing that, you get it. Postbox, mailbox. Oh, it's another Americanism. This problem happened with the Pictionary game as well. May. L.
I went blanked on how to spell mail. Box. It looked wrong. Box. Come on! Point to Mikey. We don't have mailboxes over here. I'm at a disadvantage. Where's a British company anyway? Why is it just dealing with American things? Even though I was back at Astroware, we kind of do games for everyone. So we wouldn't exclude non-Americans. It's just not cricket. Man made. I do like this though. I'll clip that bin. And put all the rest of it in my hair. Okay, this is where it's going to come to. Windmill. Well, then the music changes when you start typing it. Just make sure you get all the letters, Mikey, otherwise you lose. Come on, that was good. Did you see windmill? Be honest. I'm getting the hang of this. I like this. I do actually like this. This might be a good multiplayer game. To buy and play with Lucas when he's a bit older on the actual NES. Food. Banana. It is, isn't it? It's banana. Check it out. It's a banana and I saw it before you do it. Loving it. I don't know how this fits working, it's all about trivial pursuits. I got a 1 on the dice. Green puzzle. I don't know. Oh, I see. That's a subject, like man made is a green. Okay. What are you? I wonder if the lines are cross over so I can see. A clue. That is a door. Door. See what you see? It's not catchphrase. Oh, no. Oh, okay, good. Now you don't press anything. See, I've made that mistake before. You press something and it just throws a letter in and you lose. Half the problem with this game is the text input thingy down there. It does me nothing. That's a rubbish door. Still, you saw it. It's good enough. It's good enough to identify. I want a blue one. I've got exactly zero blues. I've got loads of yellows. I haven't even done a blue. Pizza. Yeah. Oh, I wish I'd got that in before the line was drawn. Oh. Okay. Oh no, what is it? Oh, what's that? What is it, guys? What am I not seeing? Oh, I'm doomed. What is it? Oh, draw more. Oh, I'm doomed. Falafel. Pancake. It's gone. Let's go and do it time. That was annoying. What's that? Bread? Slice? S-L-I-C-E. At least how it was what it is. Apparently not. What was that? That was a pizza. Although it didn't have any other identifying markers like pepperoni on it, so maybe I should have thought that through. This is food. Apparently. Kit Kat. A robot. An edible robot. What's that? There's no dots there. You can't just... How is that food? What are you? Bum. What are you? It was a bum. I don't know what that was. What, really? We've got to do it again? Oh, that's a different one. Windmill burger. Fire. Hair on fire. What is it? Turkey. What? A pineapple! I should have seen that sooner, really. Pepper. Le. I like the little bouncy letters. They're cool. Oh yeah, go on, do the little cross hatching. Apparently not. I mean, I'm not into this, but I am having fun. How much fun can one person have playing a board game? Apparently this much fun. which is quite a lot of fun. Natural. Is it a flower of some sort? Maybe a tree? Tree! I love the change of music, that really works. Unless I'm just hearing that in my head and it's not actually changing. It is changing. Check it out, it's a tree. It's clearly a tree. That is clearly a tree. Terrible tree. So you kind of been in the garden with a few pixels and there, and some straight lines. And then this is like preempted. It's kind of remembering the drawings that someone's designed. I did this once for a word games game for Astroware. You'll get to see them on the games I made things soon. That is some sort of sausage. It is some sort of sausage. I'm not sure what type. Yeah, I did it for... in fact, it was Astroware word games. I must have designed hundreds, if not thousands, of little drawings just on paper, which I then made in vectors. I used a little package that the company made to memorise lines being drawn, and the amount of stuff that went in there was for every word eventuality, if you can imagine such a thing. So avocado, we had a picture of avocado. I'm not sure we did. That was just picking something out of the bum. But we had all kinds of different objects, household objects. What are you, a bowling ball? A peach? A thingy? Oh, an olive? The name just went. No, it's not an olive. Oh dear. Is it an orange? Might as well try it. Apparently so. That was lucky, wasn't it? That I got it so close. I'm not really confident. No, it wouldn't have been hard. about 1,000 different objects. And of course, they all have keywords associated with them. So if you type one of 6 words in, you've got a picture of an olive. For example, you type olive, or you type cocktail, and you get an olive. You know what I mean? So if the word is cocktail, you still get the olive. There were about 1,000 images in there. And maybe it was only like 400 or 500, but it was a lot. I spent a lot of time drawing random little objects in this sort of style, but much more freehand. And they just start drawing themselves around the screen while you're playing the game, which is kind of cool. What are you? Transistor radio. That's the factory. Factory? I'll go with that. It certainly is. It was a... It's actually quite a nice game, as word games go at the time. It's a bit kind of chunky and clunky, but the stuff... Well, games were a bit more back then. I'd say check it out, but you don't have to. You'll get to see it at some point when I show you it on the game, what I have made for you, which I'm going to do some more on soon. I was going to do one tonight, but I don't really want to. I want to just play some games, because I need to enjoy myself, like Joe said. Leisure. Fishing rod. Yes, I was not seeing that at all. It's like staring me in the face. Okay, this is quite a good game. Oh no! Oh, that's me qualm with it. That's me issue with it. Fair enough, you get a chance. But look at the timer counting down there. We don't need that in our lives. Leave us alone, let us type at our own pace. I'm guessing this is as far as this goes, and it just keeps going until the end of the game. Goodness knows. Hey, a blue! It's a blue! Yeah, I got a blue, that'll do me. Oh, exit level 2, so you get one of each. I'll say goodness knows where this ends. That's cool. I'm glad we saw that before I ended the vid. I quite like that. One of the best board games I've played on a console, or an emulator in this case. That was, oh I see, now we've got a whole new set of subjects. This is really good. Okay, I'm done. Anticipation for the NES. Good little game. Thanks for watching.